Well, guys, I know it's been a while since I've posted. I've done a fair amount to the Z since then. I broke my foot. Now I'm off the cast. I posted a video of me doing some cool skids with my foot broken. Big thing that's happened since the last video is I got accepted onto the Dark Lotus Drift team. Not so much for drifting, but for media and video. And I do get out on the track lots. And if I get better, then maybe I can drive with the guys that drive so well on that team. Big shout out to them and big thanks to them helping me out and getting me on the track and getting me out doing media for them. I love doing it and get my name out there, get their name out there. Another thing is I fixed these Advan SA3s that I've had sitting around. They're 17 by 9 plus 19. They look great on here. I got some new tires for those. I did S13 front control arms. That brought the tire out a lot more, gave me a lot more camber and lowered me a lot. I did rack spacers just from an S13, and then I think they're offset rack spacers, I'm told. I don't know much about them, but they, and I also did modded knuckles. I'm pretty stoked on that. It's, I got almost double the angle. Here's kind of a before. And then an after. It definitely helped a lot. The big thing right now is my tension rods aren't adjustable, and as you can see, my wheel's sitting pretty far back in the wheel well there. I need to adjust that and bring the tire forward, give myself some more casters so that it has a lot more self-steer, because you really have to feed the wheel. I got a couple of videos there you guys can check out. I'll post them up here in this video. But yeah, so next thing is to get some S13 adjustable tension rods. I'm going to steal the brackets out of the red car because that's the later style that will fit the S13 tension rods without having to modify my bracket, and I'll just take the stock non-adjustable tension rods and shove them back in this car with new bushings. I also have new poly bushings for this style. And yeah, she's looking pretty good. She's lower than I'd like because of the camber. I think it's a little bit more than I wanted. I did a string alignment on Thursday, or on Friday actually, before I went to the track. I put all this parts in on Thursday. It took me longer than I expected, but and hopefully by next week I got adjustable tension rods and I get a proper alignment from the guys from Fountain Tire and Chilliwack. So yeah, I put on some turbo side skirts that don't quite fit. I think I'm getting some AE side skirts in the mail. I'm gonna get some vinyl probably and just throw some cool vinyl on there. But yeah, it's been pretty boring because I haven't really done many part swaps because of my broken foot. But like I said, just recently I've changed all the stuff in the front end to give me more angle. The hydro e-brake is installed in there, and I just need to run. I ordered dual caliper brackets. I got to get those welded in, and then yeah, so the hydro is in there, super nice. I'm gonna get a like a reservoir for it and probably put it back here somewhere, or we'll see, we'll hide it somewhere. But yeah, pretty stoked on how all that's working out. And then I did add a lot more stickers. I got Chubby Pikachu and all these slaps here. I'll throw these on there. So yeah, just going into it now, I'm just trying to get myself more seat time and just try and practice more and more. I'm gonna take some camber out. I'll probably run -4. Before I was running out of -5, and that everything's kind of gonna change when I get my caster in there and get a proper alignment, because the string line did not, it still drives straight and the wheel's straight, but it's a, you know, it's a string line alignment in the driveway. So yeah, that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed that, and I'm pretty excited to have my foot back and be able to work on this thing and drive it properly at the track and take pictures and video at the track. Here's a few of the pictures I've taken. On the weekend, it was an awesome sunset, and I loved it. I did media coverage for the first grassroots competition at Mission, and some really awesome drivers were out there. Pretty stoked to finish up that footage and make a video. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy it, and I'll see you next time. Hey guys, so I swapped the tension rod brackets off the late kooky model, the red car I have. I'm gonna put them in this car. That's these brackets here. They go this way instead of screwing in this way. There's a box on the other ones here and just a hole here with a couple plates on each side. And that's the way the tension rod goes in on the other ones. This one goes in with a bolt through the side, which is the same as the S13. This is my stock arm. As you can see, the bushing's pretty bad, and it's not adjustable. So this one's adjustable. I just picked these up off a buddy. Thank you so much, Cole. Super cheap. I had to modify a couple pieces of steel I got and some washers to make it work. I think it's gonna be a good temporary fix until I get the proper setup. This one over here, it has these tapered spacers. I'm gonna have to find somebody who has those, and then I can change those out. But for now, it will work to at least get me an alignment set. Maybe send it a couple track days. I had to buy a 10-foot length of this steel and spacer like the other one has, and I had to bend it in half to fit it in my car to get it home. So yeah, I just took these off of those. I got them random S13 arms with them. They're kind of cut and welded in a bad spot, and I don't really know, but they're extra, I guess, if I need them. But yeah, these adjustable arms were on those, so I had to take those off and then take the tension rods off these brackets and then put these on. So now I can start to jack up the car and start to do that.
Consider the sun up, yeah. I just wanna live my life and give you everything that I can give. Alright, alright, alright. Me and my homies live in Hollywood, but that don't mean we Hollywood. And if I could reply to every fan, hell yeah, you know I probably would. Live life till I overdose. I said it once, had to say a dose. I remember living at Mary Jo's, now I'm living like pharaohs. I work like a slave, live like a king, cause in the end I promise money ain't a thing. I know that I got it, yeah, we got it over here. I know that I got it, yeah, we got it all, yeah. Just me and my homies living life over here. Couple bad bitches that are right, oh yeah. I know that I got it if I take my time. I know that I got it, everything will be fine. Couldn't wait to get it, now we got it over here. city lights, getting lost in the pretty lights. Yeah, shout out to Maryland, shout out Chicago, shout out beautiful women that follow where I go. Cause I know I got no time for these fake hoes and these fake rhymes. We live it up in these great times, always on my mind. This is real life, real life. Okay, I guess this is what it feel like, real life. Just me and my homies, do you realize? This the type of shit I used to prophesy.
Okay, I don't know how well you can see them there, but I got the adjustable tension rods in on both sides. I pulled the wheel pretty far forward. I'm gonna put the tire on and see how it sits. Maybe I'll just set the other side the same and put it on the ground and check it and adjust it if needed. But yeah, there's adjustable tension rods done, both sides. A little bit of messing around, but it's going pretty good. Can't wait to try it out at the track, I guess, and see if it makes a difference. It should. Everybody says that that's my problem, so just gonna listen to the drift kids. All right. So the arms, they don't have a ton of threads out on each side, so there's lots of thread grabbing. Apparently the S14 ones are longer. It fits really good in the late style brackets. Looks pretty even on the heim joint and everything. And over here it actually is kind of notched to go around the control arm, so it's actually not bad. So I had to pull, they're actually a slightly shorter length set than the stock ones, because I had to pull the arm forward about an inch, I guess, or 3/4 of an inch. I pulled the whole wheel forward, so yeah, they installed pretty easily with the kooky arms, or the kooky brackets. So yeah. So the adjustable tension rods are in. Modded knuckles, extended arms, which are just stock S13. They're about an inch longer than my stock arms. And then the modded knuckles are cut about 3/4 of an inch shorter than the stock knuckles. I also have rack spacers in there, the offset rack spacers, and the adjustable tension rods. The wheels now sit really nicely in the wheel well. I'll turn the wheel and we can check that out. Got my custom Z center button. Ryan Turk shift knob, hydro e-brake, nice distance from the wheel. Loving that. I just need to get some new seats probably. Maybe put some padding on my roll-up window thing, because when the windows are all the way down, my knee rams into it and I get a pretty big bruise on my knee. So a couple little things for the track days, but as you can see, they sit much nicer in the wheel well. They're not as far back at all. So pretty stoked to try those out and see how that helps to control the car in a slide, and hopefully I can get to transitioning and slaying the whole track every time. But it's definitely looking better. I need to get an alignment still, but definitely an improvement.